I like this, man.
Nice and quiet out here, ain't it?
Yeah.
Listen, I know how stressful the season is. Just trying to give you a way to relieve it.
Appreciate you, bro.
Anytime.
How long you been doing this for?
Been fishing since I was like 2. That's how me and my dad bought.
Yeah, I heard you got invited to MJ's golf tournament.
Yeah, that's gonna be off the chain. Definitely going to there.
Can I go with you?
Nah.
All right.
No plus one.
All right, welcome back to A New Place, NBA 2K18. I'm SRD, and we just got a phone call here, or a text message. Let's see who it's from. It's from... We got a couple here. Of course, that cutscene you saw was me fishing with Paul George. Just taking it easy, doing some relaxing in between games. Let's see what Brian has to say here first. I have some endorsement money for you to pick up my office. Cool. I'll stop. I'm going to stop by. I don't know how much it is. So let's go. Let's see what LeVar Ball wants here. Nike's for chumps. That's where small ballers who want to go. So it'd be me and Lonzo. Why? The lips of Zeus. What the? Come to Big Baller Brand. Is this really LeVar Ball? Have I seen this before? I might have seen this one before. Okay, let's go pick up our money. Nike should be happy with me. I've been sporting nothing but Nikes. What's up? Brian? What's up, Brian?
You have something for me?
I do indeed. Here you go.
Nice, man.
Ew, sweet. All right. Can't complain about that now. Took me up to 3,500 VC. Okay. I am going to get some practice in, and then we're going to get into a game. So, catch you later.
It's game time, baby.
Come on, let's do this.
We got this.
Sir.
DJ, a quick game of Rochambeau, I bet you can't beat me.
Ooh. Okay, let's do it.
All right.
Come on, DJ.
He got lucky, bro. Look, ain't nobody ever beat me. All right, let's do it. 2 out of 3.
All right. Get him, D.
1, 2, 3.
Man, let me get this. I'll beat this clown.
Listen, sir, please. Nobody's ever beat me on my home court. And nobody should ever beat you on yours. So y'all stop sweating me and go out there and show them how it's done. I told you I'm undefeated. Y'all can't say that.
Man.
Let's go. Let's take on the Utah Jazz, see if we can keep the streak going.
We have an interconference affair lined up for you today as the Utah Jazz come in for this one. 2K Sports brings you Friday night NBA action. And both these teams can go deep into their benches. Chris, what's it like to play on a stacked team? A team that has a huge number.
All right, let's go. Time to jump it.
It just relieves a
little tip off. Come on.
You want to try to get a lead or play.
Oh, I lost that one.
The bench comes in and just holds off the next
team. That's not a bad omen.
Comes in with a nice pace. But when you're playing with a great team, you can actually hope that bench comes in and do better than you. You can actually hope that bench comes in and raises the pace on that other team. But most importantly, what those benches do, and I know for me in Sacramento, they really keep the integrity of the team in practice every day because they're out there beating the A-team.
So all right, Kyrie's off to a hot start.
One hates or has to flip their jersey inside out and go up against the starters. They're playing with that confidence that they play with every game, and so you have to be prepared in practice. And so it makes every day you get better, not just on the game day. So for me, being on those teams with great benches helps you more in practice every day, which sets a culture of winning more so than just in the games.
That's an excellent insight. And checking out Utah's opening lineup, we've got
They start off with a three.
Is out there with Yurebko. Then there's Alec Burks, and it's Rubio in at the point guard. Hayward on the wing. Here's the screen.
Oh, get up. Come on. Rebounded by the Jazz. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Chicago.
Tough night. I mean, they attacked on both ends, and unfortunately for them, they just got called for a lot of fouls.
Oh, no question. Officials were active, trying to keep control of the game that affected the substitution pattern.
Just five on the clock. Here's Rubio. Not really his range, and it's off target. Celtics have gone 1-3 for the field to start this one so far.
Oh, nice.
No doubt about that one.
And as a wing player, Hayward is so good at attacking the basket. I think that's a big part of what makes him special. Doesn't take much of an opening for Hayward to make his move.
And Rubio kicks to Yarebko. Now, here's Burks, guarded by Smart.
Out of bounds,
Boston takes possession.
Don't even try it. Brick wall, buddy.
Here's Smart. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Passes it to the monster. Tries again.
Oh my God!
So Utah will take it the other way.
Chance
of the season for them to go
you know,
up
I boost my
Celtics
points up for the inside shooting, and didn't look
for
it.
Them as they were swept in the two-game series from last year.
Yeah, for sure. This is a team that feels like they should never be swept in the season series by anyone, but especially when it comes to one of the heavy hitters from the other conference.
Yeah, getting that,
here's
man.
Irving.
Woo! Oh!
Rubio with the rebound.
Beautiful move.
Utah's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Oh, man. Kyrie missed a shot. Comes down, fouls the guy.
And, you know, for all the talk about Rubio's passing, I think one thing that gets overlooked is his defense. Both his on the ball and defensive rebounding are very strong for the point guard position. And Ricky Rubio, you know, known mostly for his ability to pass it and create opportunities for teammates. But, you know, I think he's an underrated defender at that point guard spot. And maybe he doesn't get the credit he deserves defensively.
It's good. Irving's got his second basket of the night.
Irving's just an exceptional scorer. So effortless. You got to appreciate his shooting for him.
Here's the screen. Rubio, the pass to Burks. Here's your Yarebko, guarded by Horford. Another miss by Utah. The Celtics have gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Here's Irving.
How did I pass it? I did not hit the freaking pass button.
Good D by Rubio. Now, here's Burks, guarded closely. And Rubio kicks to Ingles. Now, Yarebko. 11 points for him in that last game against Chicago. They grabbed their own miss.
Oh, Udo, bullshit.
Bucket. Udo's got his first 2 points of the night. Several lead changes.
Yeah, come on.
Early portion of this game.
It reminds me of that cameo song, Back and Forth.
Hayward kicks to Horford, and there's the foul.
All right, through the foul.
That's his
trying
first
to foul me over. A little acting on my part. Good to go.
Utah's on defense. Irving attacking. There's the pass to the monster. After 2 minutes,
all right, finally,
the game, he's on the board with that shot made.
And just a nice combination of size and feel there. Terrific finish down low.
Rubio dishes to Udo.
Mm-mm.
Rebound by the
give me that board too.
From a win against the Nuggets.
Bring it down, Smart.
And once they established that flow offensively, really never got any resistance from the defense.
All right.
And I feel like
good
the defense
flow, good
one
flow.
Step behind all night. I mean, they never made the adjustments to string together a few stops.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Nice ball movement by Utah.
Oh, damn it.
Good work there as it goes.
Oh, he's shooting a fantastic.
I thought he was going to go baseline on you, man.
The Celtics have gone just a shade under 50% from the field. 5 of 11. Hayward against Ingles. And there are the Celtics with another
come
basketball.
On, you're not going to give me the good screen?
No
thank you.
Left in the defense there after a teeth-rattling pick.
Rubio, the pass to Yarebko.
There's another Keith Rattley.
Six to shoot. From 12 feet out. The shot that time, not on target. Now the Celtics take it the other way. In the corner, Horford with it. Smart with the ball, and Burks picks him up defensively. Smart passes to the monster. It's tipped.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Here's Ingles. Udo dishes to Jurebko. And it's sent back.
I blocked that one.
Oh, the way Horford.
Somebody blocked it. Oh, okay. Horford got it. What am I doing, ball handling?
Just absolutely fantastic.
Go ahead, Kyrie. It's all yours.
Now here's Smart. Burks covering.
Smart. I'm sorry.
Made it look too easy. Jazz trail by six.
Isolation on Smart there.
Celtics have stars with Hayward and Kyrie Irving, but their strength is
there. All right, we're up by six. We got 2 points, got three boards. Hey, Shammy's in.
Then it's Marcus Morris, and it's Abrines in at the small forward position. That's the Boston Five. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. Chris, it's hard at times to see just how effective a post player is on the defensive end beyond the blocks. What's the one thing that shows you a post player is doing an excellent job of defending
for
their
team? That's
good. Come
on.
Well, look at the penetration of a great guard. Right now, guards are playing at such a high level and they're quicker. So when you see a guard attack, notice if that big man comes
over
and has both feet planted. He doesn't have to get a charge, doesn't have to block. But does he stay vertical and does he get over there fast enough that the offensive guard that was trying to score can't get his shot up and has to change, either pass the ball or continue his dribble? Right now, a lot of defense is done by just being in the correct spot at the right time, because you're not going to block the shot, or you just want to deter the player from coming in. And so I would say watch how that player
goes, Shammy.
Paid defensively, not necessarily high block shots, but by where he is on his position.
Shammy gets so
soft. Penetration for guards coming up top.
Oh, that's a great
ten.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the monster in the last game against the Nuggets just played phenomenal.
We're talking about me.
And that scoring outburst set a new season high for him in what became a great
defensive breakdown.
He put up numbers that really jumped out in the box score. A very solid performance. Kevin, we'll see what he's got in his arsenal tonight.
All right, David, thank you, guys. Could you believe that performance? Wow.
I mean, it was really something to see. Yeah, he showed everybody just how special he is when he is on his game.
Oh, yeah. Once he got them on the ropes, he never let them off the hook. It was full speed basketball at his greatest.
Mitchell cranes it from beyond the arc. Mitchell's got five now. Celtics leading by five. Pass to the monster. Feeds to Wells.
Come on, Shammy.
Again,
boom!
Boston with the triple.
All right.
This really is the story of the game. They've been outstanding from beyond the arc, especially in the second quarter.
Hood kicks to Jurebko. He feeds it to Hood. And it's Jurebko, top of the key. The rebound by the Celtics. The Monsters got three rebounds.
Not taking that one from me.
Here's Morris.
Oh, come on, right there. And one.
Right with it, gets the foul. With the bucket, and he'll go to the line.
They've settled into a nice groove offensively here in the second.
By 10 again.
The Celtics making a change here. Hayward's checked in. Utah also making some changes. Joe Ingles is checked in for Johnson. Alec Burks comes in for Cephalosha. And Ricky Rubio subbed in for Rodney Hood.
While the shooting of Morris provides his team with his crucial, just a real valuable part of this team.
Jurebko, the pass to Mitchell. And stolen by Kyrie Irving. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Here's Abrines. Yes, and
boom.
It's Irving picking up the assist. Abrines has got his second basket.
That's just outstanding awareness from Irving right there. Remarkable at finding his guys when they're wide open.
Ingles with a screen on Morris. And Rubio kicks to Jurebko. Pass to Ingles. to end the run and count it. He'll head to the line with a chance to make it three.
Too many inches being given up in that matchup. I mean, he's got no chance of putting a stop to that layup.
Al Horford has checked in for Morris. The Jazz have had two chances at the line already, making them both.
And the Utah Jazz, historically, they've always been one of the better franchises in the NBA. And it was nice to see them back in the playoffs in 2017 after that four-year rebuilding phase. It tied their longest playoff drought since the team moved to Utah.
Here's the monster. So the whistle blows. Ooh. On the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there. Now let's take a look at how the shots have been divided up between three-point shots and two-point shots for the Celtics.
They are shooting the lights out from beyond on really limited attempts. So you have to think they ought to feed those hot hands on the perimeter and see if they can keep this thing going.
Utah calls timeout.
All right, so we're up by 12. 5:30 to go in the half.
Throughout the decades, Boston's been unafraid to pull the trigger. I mean, they moved up to number two to draft the great Bill Russell, moving back to number three to draft McHale, at Parrish, assembling the big three for a championship, then dismantling that big three for all.
Man, what a team the Celtics had back there in the 80s, early 90s.
To try and win title.
Boston making a switch here. Smart's checked in.
Ugliest team in basketball between Parrish and McHale.
And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in.
Who else was on
Mitchell's
there?
Got 7 points.
He just looks more engaged in the second quarter, a far cry from his disappointing play in the first period.
And, you know, thinking about Kyrie's legacy here in Boston, this is a town that cares only about championships. That's how his contribution is going to be measured. And only time will tell if he can walk in the shoes of the greatest players to ever
put
on
still
a Celtics uniform.
There's the pick. The dish to Ingles. A three-pointer off the mark. Celtics leading by 10. To the middle. He had stolen by Ingles.
I didn't even know what I was doing with the ball, man.
The lead now in single digits. Burks has got his second bucket of the night.
That was big because they dug a big hole in the first quarter, but starting to show signs of life.
The Celtics working the ball around now. Now here's Smart. He's guarded closely. He dishes it to Irving. Four on the clock. Here's the monster.
Get it.
The rebound.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
I don't know about that.
Rubio
a lot more credit than I'm due, that's for sure. Come on.
Burks dishes to Mitchell.
Lockdown.
No good.
Give me that.
Triple.
Yeah.
Boston's gone 5 of 8 from 3-point land. 15 points and a deep ball for them tonight.
Get it. All right, we got a look. Ooh, I get the assist.
Off the dribble, Smart showing the body control on that shot.
They set the screen. And Rubio kicks to Repko.
That's off.
And Irving pulls it down.
The D pretty much taking that possession off, but the shot's off target with nobody near.
Kyrie's taking that one.
That is his fourth basket of the night.
I could have been wide open. I never would have got the ball.
So dependent.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Mitchell passes to Burks. Over Hayward. Burks can't get it to go.
Hey, look, that's what they want. The ball is in his hands in the post. Just didn't have the touch that time.
Hayward can't hit.
Watch the
Jazz
foul.
Trail by 13.
We'll go the back.
Dishes at Dwingles. That's in. Coming off an assist.
Defensive breakdown.
Ingles has got 5 points.
How was that a defensive breakdown? We're up by 11.
Call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. And Chris, you were the number one overall draft pick back in 1993. We've seen a lot of greats taken with that pick, but it also seems that those number one picks who aren't
not having a great half, scoring wise,
criticism. There's a lot on your plate to handle. Can you talk about that for us?
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure for some players being the number one pick. But I've always laughed and I've thought about, you know, players that maybe people say maybe they were a bust, maybe this player wasn't good. Well, I think you should go
I
back.
I thought I had that board, man.
Pick them. I mean, the GM is the guy that assesses talent, you know. So when there were a few players that were picked number one, and many players said, "What are you doing? You've played against him." We would never pick him number one. So before that, I think the NBA is about opportunity and situation. Look at a guy like Chauncey Billups.
No shot.
Boston. He didn't do well at Boston. They called him a malcontent, said he couldn't play, and then he ended up being one of the best leaders that the game had. And so this game is all about situation and opportunity. Can you find the right fit? That's why if you're a player, you can't let frustration get to you. You have to continue to work hard, continue to prove your game, because when you play, you're auditioning for the other teams.
Oh, come on, man. I thought I had a position.
We see his unique talent skills,
brother?
We see his unique skill set, and we could use him. And so many times, you just have to wait for the right position, the right situation.
Irving kicks to Horford. Now here's Smart. Burks covering. 107 left in the first half of basketball. Here's Smart. Hits the target from 18.
All right, I'll take the assist on that.
7 points in the game.
Even though I meant to shoot.
Advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Why? I hit the square.
And Rubio kicks to Yarebko. Burks dishes to Ingles. Here's a good screen.
Get out of here. Look at that. Ooh, that was beautiful.
Here's Boston. Irving.
Come on, Kyrie. Oh, come on, convert.
Point in the first, but still searching for that second.
Beautiful block like that,
he's
man.
Picked up by Irving. A wide open look here for Ingles from outside, off the mark. 5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And it's Hayward. That time on the assist by Irving. Irving's got 3 assists tonight.
That's just another one for Hayward. He's built up his body. Now he has the strength and endurance to score at will.
Rubio against Irving. Now, here's Rubio. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Bulls in Chicago.
Oh, and he also was a badger on the defense again, finishing with 3 steals in the
match. Thank
so
goodness.
Boston up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter.
All right.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with head coach Brad Stevens. Coach, what did you think was the main edge you had?
Well, I thought defensively we were a lot better, and then that led to some offense. But obviously, we're playing a bunch of skilled guys, and we're able to.
Thank you, David, for that interview. Yeah,
thank you.
And we'll see you back here after the break.
All right, how did I do? Not that great. 5 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists, and a beautiful block shot. My only problem is that there's time. Keep it good, but let's finish strong. All right.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down.
Let's do this right.
Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
Yeah, and sometimes you find yourself in a role you're not comfortable with, but his passing in the first half really was impressive.
Yeah, some of it is based on how the defense is playing you. He didn't force things. Instead, he rewarded his teammates.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. So on the floor for Utah, we've got your Yarebko. Ricky Rubio is out there with Alec Burks.
Nice shooting.
And it's Joe Ingles, and it's Udo in at the center, filling out the middle.
I mean, Al Horford has a complete game. He can hit a big shot, he can get a defensive stop, and even setting a great screen. And let's not forget about his pass, he does it all.
14 feet away. And it's Kyrie Irving with the
Kyrie
rebound.
Gets the board.
Irving's got his third rebound tonight. Tries it from 19. And the shot no good. A bit short.
I like the shot selection on that one, despite the miss.
Ingles, that's for two. Rebounded by the Monster.
The Monster gets the board. To this game. Number nine.
Irving passes to the Monster.
And one. Come on, let's go.
And this is what you want Irving doing, breaking down the D with his moves and getting the guys involved. I love his unselfishness.
The Celtics have shot 5 of 8 from the foul line.
Yeah, looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
Burks kicks to Udo. Nice ball movement by Utah.
The field to Wiggles.
Yurenko dishes to Rubio. Udo, the pass to Burks. Over Smart. Another miss by Utah.
Third straight miss.
Got out rebounded by Wolf.
Still early. No need to panic.
He kicks to Irving. Passes it to Horford. In the corner, it's Hayward.
And another. And
play opportunity.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball.
All right, let's go.
And of course, NBA players have all reached this pinnacle through dedication.
Oh, come on, man. 68%.
The hard work and effort that goes into playing and succeeding at this NBA level.
Well, no. You get out. Oh, you got to be. No way that guy got in there.
At the movies, you're on the basketball court.
Shoot.
When your friends are hanging out at a party, you're at the basketball court. When your friends and his family are on vacation, you're at the basketball court. I don't think many people understand the dedication. You know, for many guys, it's more than 4 hours a day in the gym. And a lot of that is just sitting in the gym, just smelling the gym. You know, of course you're going to work out. Of course you're going to shoot. It's everything basketball. You know,
what the heck was that about, man?
Dominique, Magic, Bird. I had all these guys, Isaiah, cut out magazines, and I would put their pictures on my wall and work out and do push-ups looking at them. And
no
I would
kidding.
Know. I would know their moves. I would know everything. You know, I remember Kenny Smith after his dunk contest, he stood at the free throw line and threw the ball between his legs, threw it off the backboard and
come on, Gary. Yes, there's another assist for me.
Snow,
ooh, how about a triple double? That would be exciting.
I mean, you have to love it. So, you know, when you love something, my father taught me,
there
is not
go.
Work.
Yet.
And so you got to start with the love, and then all the other work and dedication is just part of it.
Yeah, we've kind of stretched our lead a bit.
Johnson, he's checked in for Yurepko. Cephalosha comes in for Joe Ingles, and Hood subbed in for Alec Burks.
Yeah, we'll get him a guy. He could have gone to the board there.
And Rubio kicks to Udo. Shot from 12. It's rebounded by the Monster.
Forget it.
The success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Irving double.
Kyrie's good. Oh, I didn't think I was going to get the pass.
Out to Morris. 16 feet away. Bounces.
And there's another assist for me, right? No, that's just the screen.
Morris has got 8 points.
Didn't give
Morris
me the screen assist.
From mid-range. He's very effective. Love seeing him getting it going from there.
Johnson kicks to Cephalosha. Out to the wing. Here's Udo. Uses the glass to finish the layup. He's got 6.
Look at this. I like this. Team basketball. Keeping the ball moving until they find the right shot.
Kicks it to Hayward. The Monster passes to Morris. Here's the Monster. He's guarded by Johnson. Hayward outside.
Put it up, man.
From deep. And there's the call on Shammy Wells. That is his first
Shammy.
Call of the game.
Some what are you doing, man? Austin.
Alex Abrines comes in for Gordon Hayward. And it's Rozier in for Irving. And Utah also making a switch. Mitchell's checked in. Hood kicks to Johnson. Banked in off the glass. Johnson's got his second basket of the game.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
Abrines, the pass to the Monster. Feeds it to Wells. Here's Rozier. Oh, good with the triple. Jazz trail by 20. Hood kicks to Cephalosha. Johnson outside. Now the pass to Mitchell. Here's Hood.
Nope.
Again, the Jazz score.
I got by him. He got position. The guy
Wyatt so
made
far
the shot
offensively,
anyway.
Searching for his first points of the game. To the middle. Here's the Monster. It's rebounded by Udo. Udo's
F
got
me.
Double-digit rebounds now in the game.
Let's go.
Stripped it away. Here's Rozier.
over Hood. Well, put it up already, dude. And he overshot. Oh my God.
Jazz trail by 18. Wells with the steal. And now Wells.
Go ahead, Shammy.
No one back to stop him.
And Wells covers a lot of ground quickly. Phenomenal at running in transition and then capitalizing with ease.
And that replay presented by Under Armour showing us the fantastic steal that led to that fast break finish. Another unleash chaos moment. Here's the screen. Hood kicks to Johnson. Johnson the screen. Shot clock at 5. Here's Cephalosha, the 15-footer. Good. Cephalosha's got 7 points.
Let's go, Shammy.
Leading by 18. Wells passes to the monster. And there's the foul. It'll go on Udo. That's his 3rd foul of the game.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Exum, he's checked in for Utah.
And I'm on the bench. Do I come back in the 4th of November?
So Utah.
Kind of an average game, really. Nothing exciting here.
Has checked in for Udo. Joe Ingles comes in for Mitchell. Burks, he's checked in for Hood. And Ricky Rubio is subbed in for Exum. Horford is out there with Hayward. Then there's Irving. Then there's the Monster. And it's Smart in at the 2 spot. That's the Boston 5.
Oh.
The Monster. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
He's been a
Come
different
on,
guy
where's the foul?
The second half. His shooting percentage far better than it was before the break.
Jazz trail by 18. Rubio outside. Got a piece of it. And stolen by Kyrie Irving. In the corner, it's Hayward. Fires from deep. Doesn't go for him. So Utah will take it the other way. And Rubio kicks to Cephalosha. And Cephalosha with the jam.
Oh, he caught him in stride with the lead pass. Now that was timing.
Pass to the Monster. Out to Hayward. They set the pick. He feeds it to Smart. 6 to shoot. Pass to the Monster. Rubio with the rebound.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
Johnson outside.
Make up your mind, Kenny.
Burks on the wing. A floater. Rebound by the Monster. The Monster's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. Here's Irving. Offensive rebound. Second chance shot. No good from the Monster. And the foul on the Monster. That's his 1st foul. Udo's checked in for Utah. Nurepko comes in for Cephalosha. Jazz trail by 16. And Rubio kicks to Nurepko. Pass to Udo. There's the pick. Back to Ingles. 3-pointer. Rebound Boston. Smart's got his 3rd rebound tonight. There's the dish to Irving. Here's the Monster. On its way from Hayward for 2. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper.
And you can see there the defender gets caught up on the pick.
Team ball. Great execution on offense. Everyone working together. You wish you could have that on every play.
Udo with the ball.
Ah.
Easy 2 points on the layup.
And that's what the pump fake's there for. Get your
went,
man off.
Went with the fake, man.
Drive
got
right
me.
Around.
Irving kicks to Horford. In the corner, Smart with it. To the paint. Here's the Monster. Rebounded by the Jazz. Udo's got 11 rebounds in the game.
Sometimes, man. Know what I gotta do.
Rubio outside. Stolen by Smart. And Ricky Rubio gets the whistle that time.
That's a little frustration foul there. Sorry, Kyrie. I didn't mean to neglect you.
Irving passes to the monster. Horford kicks to Smart. Celtics passing it around. Count that one.
Oh my God, it went in.
Points for the monster.
Thank you for that pass.
Jazz trail by 18. Rubio dishes to Jurepko. There's a good screen. Now, here's Burks. Guarding close.
Get out of here. Look at that. Another beautiful block, man. Let's score this time, Kyrie. Offensively, as they try to get back in this Smart goes up. Oh, come on, man.
Interior D there prevents the Duke.
Oh, wonderful anticipation. He reads the play perfectly. Then with the quick reaction time.
And Rubio kicks to Udo.
Where you going? Where you going? Where you going? Where you going? Didn't think so. Uh-oh.
Over Smart buries it from about 10 feet away.
Oh, great awareness. No reason to take it inside there against the taller man.
Well, he created a little separation from that mid-range. Just a good shot for him in that situation.
Utah with the rebound. And here's
why do I increase my
on the wing Ingles dishes it to Jurepko. Rubio in the corner, 5 on the clock, shoots a 3, knocked away, but he gets it back, and there's the feed to Ingles, back to Rubio. There's a screen to the paint. Here's Burks. It's rebounded by the monster.
He's the key if they're going to make a run. He's been way off this court.
Irving passes to the monster. Loses his man on
here's
the screen
hook.
And lays it up and in. The
monster's really
got
layup.
6 here in this quarter.
This is a hook.
Trailed by 18. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Ingles kicks to Burks. Off the screen, pops loose off the pick and hammers it home.
And a sturdy screen set for him that time. And he doesn't fool around, just straight to the rim for the finish.
No way for his man to get around that one. That's for sure.
You're right. I'll take it.
Precise in how they ran that play. Exceptional timing. That's all good stuff.
You can't lay that pass in there any better.
Utah's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Rubio dishes to Jurepko. Now, here's Burks, guarded by Smart. Off the screen. Burks can't get it to go.
Look, it would be a huge boost for them if he could start knocking these down.
Horford kicks to Irving. Got it. Good job in the low post. And the Celtics lead by 20. The Cowboys, Marcus Smart.
Not a bad game, really.
Popping numbers, Chris, but they love what he brings to the table.
Solid,
yeah, it's
solid
all about his heart. I mean, his offensive game has been.
They gave me the player of the game again.
He doesn't shoot great percentages.
Okay.
When his team needs him most, it seems like he always has a big impact on the game.
Right, that's like 2 or 3 times this season now.
He's
the
just
game.
A good luck charm for them. He's almost like the leprechaun.
And Utah making a change here. Hood's checked in. And Rubio kicks to Jurepko. Feeds to Hood to the inside. And the
come on, fellas. What's that?
Those passes into the paint have to be precise, just like that one.
Now Irving. And there's the pass to the monster. In the corner, Smart with it. They set the screen. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Udo picks one up.
At 6'4", 220 pounds, Marcus Smart might be the most physically imposing point guard in the
come
league,
on, Marcus.
Especially with his fiery approach to the game.
So he can't get either to fall. Jazz trail by 18. Up top, Rubio. Covered by Irving. He used that pick to get in close. 6 points for Ricky Rubio.
Oh, the floater's a tough shot, even when you're that close to the bucket.
Irving kicks to Horford. Here's the monster. Count the man.
You can't stop.
The monster's got 20 points.
Just terrific determination. First, compiling the lead, and now building on it.
Oh, man, and this is late in the game. It's tough for a team to come back. Everything has to fall into place.
To the inside. It's stolen by Udo.
And so okay.
Just rolling to the finish line now. And
could have thrown it when I was
very
open.
Confident-looking performance for the Celtics.
You know, it's tough to put this and so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. They won this game going away.
All right, that is the game. Not a bad game for me. Pretty solid. Unleash Chaos trophy earned. Had a couple good blocks there. Team good screens, man. I'm a screen in full. 4 for 6 from the line. Not bad, not bad. $8,100. Not bad at all, really. My VC balance is going up. That's good. 10 points per game. My average is slowly going up.
Kevin, thank you. Another double-double for you this year, points and rebounds. Now, is that something you're looking to do when you go out there?
Man, I'm not looking to do anything because let me tell you something. I don't count stats. I'm a basketball player. I'm not an accountant. You know what I'm saying? Whatever my stats end up being, that's what it is. And I'm just happy with the numbers because, you know, at the end of the day, numbers are numbers. What really matters is how many wins we get.
You have got a lot of wins because of what you did tonight. Thanks. Back to you guys.
David, thank creepy. You as always. Well, folks, all right. That's going to do it for now. For
Chris 20 points, 4 assists, 14 boards, A+.
DJ Money. Hey, don't even say it.
What?
Hold on to it, DJ Money.
Okay, well, that is going to be it for this episode. If you liked the episode, leave a like. If you haven't yet subscribed, I'd appreciate it if you would. And we'll catch you next time on A Noob Plays NBA 2K18. Peace out. Bye.